I really like it when I hear that garage is an oasis for artists and for curators and for people in Moscow.
I remember the first time I visited garage, I said to myself, oh, this is the place where I should be. This is a place where I should live and die.
Any person can find something to do here.
You can participate in an exhibition, or you might want to join in with a conversation or a talk that's going on, or you might want to bring your kids to a workshop.
So that means that people are ready for doing something more than just, you know, coming, perceiving and like being very stable in their position. They try to be more involved.
I can honestly put my hand on my heart and say that Garage has the most high quality exhibitions, not only in terms of content and curatorial approach, but also in terms of installation and production quality.
The main mission of the Garage is education. We are interested in bringing in different cultures from all around the world and sharing the ideas of these cultures through contemporary art.
And we decided to make education to every exhibition. So it was movies, some lectures, open workshops. And when we started it, we understood that it's people more and more coming to these education programs, and they even not sometimes visiting exhibitions.
We deal with all kinds of historical researchers in the field of Russian art history. Documents, photographs, rare articles which were never published. Many things are being forgotten in a very short period of time, so we have to keep it.
We have a small publishing arm at the Garage. We translate about 20 books a year. There is no other institution who has been focused on putting together an archive of contemporary Russian art, so that makes us very unique.
Victor Miziano made a very interesting description of Garage. He said that he's the only place in Russia where he feels belonging to some international context, but he can still speak Russian. So I felt somehow like very proud to be, you know, part of this very ambitious project.